This video is sponsored by Loot Crate. Use the coupon code EvilViking13 to get 10% off of your order and help support the channel. Hey folks, Dave the Not So Evil, EvilViking13 here, and welcome back to my Let's Build project here at the Sunshine Tidings Co-op, which is actually going to be a Minutemen boot camp, as you guys are well aware. I have made it through some great vacation, and of course the Christmas and New Year's holidays. Hope you guys had a great break if you got one. I know I definitely did. And I'm ready to get the last few areas of this Minutemen boot camp completed, and we'll get that full tour rolling with Joel, and you guys will finally get to see a couple of the extra areas that I have been keeping secret. But today, we're going to work on this overlook tower, which is looking pretty rickety and floaty right now. But first, I want to work on a few things here in our central fortress at the boot camp. I'm setting up this decking area to be basically the little mini parade ground. I wish I had a bit more space, but if I go into free cam for a second, you guys can see. Go up. Space is at a premium now that we've taken up the central area with our obstacle course. And of course the gigantic shooting range. So let's go back over here. I'll just have to make this small parade ground for just small speeches work. Down here though, in the first floor of the fortress, I've got one of our primary power sources, and I think I'm gonna make this like a utility room down here. And there's our corner staircases. But because this directly connects right into the classroom, I was thinking this small space right here is going to be a little mini Minutemen museum. And then, you know, some power armor storage over here on that side. So, first things first, let's wait for the workshop to open. And I'm going to look at our concrete walls here. Yeah, I think I'll use this one with the grate in it. Where is that wanting to snap? I'll just place it there and then use place everywhere to scoot it. Let's see. Like that. I know that snapping is getting a bit weird in here because I'm creating some very unusual spaces with all of these shapes. There's our doorway. Let's just turn object snapping off for a minute, as well as surface snapping. And I will just place this corner door manually. Second thought, that's not really a whole lot of space for anything else power related. What other power generators do I have that would not be noisy? I have the compact backup generator. That's for my Minutemen mod, I believe. Don't have the batteries for the solar panels. Yeah, the compact backup's really the only option. Will it fit well anywhere in here, though? It's kind of in the walkway. If I did it like that though, I could actually build it into the wall a bit. Perhaps put one of our access computers on top. Let's try this. That's what I'm thinking, under electronics, I think under miscellaneous. We've got some fake terminals here, just for decoration, not actually usable. That is exactly what I was looking for, but I think if I can put some kind of fake shelf on top of the generator, that'll help how it looks. Oh, that's actually battery shelves. Very specific. Oops, did not mean to actually build that. Well, I was trying to go for some kind of shelf that would make it look like it had been built on top of the reactors, but there's no real way to do that without making it look like everything's just clipping together. So instead, I'm gonna scoot it aside. And I think my backup generator is making everything else hard to click on here. It has a very large hitbox on it. I do like this lamp for the power room, though. I think that's actually the one that's on the side of a lot of these fusion generators out in the wasteland. Let's try this again. Okay, place that like that. Connect that. Put our fake terminal on top. No shelf. Just gonna leave it just like that. And then a stool for sitting on, and that should do it. Or I could actually give him a task chair. Let's do that. Okay. Is there a version of that concrete wall that has the grating on it? I actually don't remember. There's the big one. I'm looking for just the grate. Okay, well, I want to fill it in with a grate because it would be silly just to have an open window into the utility room. And I think I know how I can do it. Let's go to Homemaker, fences. The other fences, I guess. And let's grab a piece of this security stuff right here. I'm just going to glitch that right inside. And that'll make up the interior of the window, basically. Cool. That'll also give our entranceway a nice, clean look to it. Honestly, I'm not sure how the Minutemen would have built all of this concrete structure into a castle. It would have taken a ridiculous amount of resources, but hey, the concrete is official Bethesda DLC, so I guess it's canon. Let's go ahead and make a quick save. The last thing we're gonna do is add our utility room door. While I'm already over here in the homemaker doors, I'm gonna see what's available here. Oh, look at that, an actual utility door. That'll do the trick. That brings us to our little Minuteman Museum. I'm gonna place our American and Minutemen flags first. Don't worry, I can tell that we're clipping. Where's the other one? There it is, right past it. We're gonna resize these. Looks like one click should do it, 90%. Before I add any more decorations, let's look at our display cases. Number one. And then a second one, I think, here in the open part of the hallway. That centered? That is not centered. Looking good, looking good. That can go back a bit more. Center that up too. Oh yeah, we have actual power armor display options here. Let's use one of those. And it has its own light. That's cool. I think I used those last in the Ten Pines Bluff vault. That leaves our mail armor stand. And our female armor stand. And some room for Minutemen banners and whatnot. So this will serve as a inspirational area for new recruits. I just gotta figure out what I'm gonna put in there. Let's get rid of that light bulb too and place some nicer lights. I won't go with the colored lights because they tend to bleed through everything. I was thinking about maybe one of these spotlights, but as you guys can tell here, it's just so dim. This looks more like a rave than anything. Yeah, no colored lights. Let's just do something simple. How bright are these fancy lights? Oh, they're not bright at all. Jeez. How about the track lights? Let's do one right here and see how it looks. There we go. We can control the lighting a bit more with the spotlights then. One here for that center display case. Oh, don't grab the entire ceiling there. I put it there and then rotate it with place everywhere. It should do like that. Nice. Don't want to go too crazy with the lights, but I will put some of these chandeliers here just to help light up the entranceway. That is not even close to the same height. What am I doing? There we go. I guess I can put them next to this doorway too. I also want to see if in this space at the end of the museum we can actually fit some of the bookshelves. Oh yeah, look at that. Got your Minutemen library right there. Gotta resize that one notch. Now it fits right in that little alcove. These guys need power connections, and wow, they're still not even. I don't think a magazine rack really fits with the rest of the museum, so I will leave it be. Some potted plants might, though. Oh, that puts us into the miscellaneous category, though. That's where everything is. I do have these really cool armor stands that I haven't made great use of. What do these cost to build? Not too much. Instead of trying to equip the armor rack, ooh, my FPS. Let's just use a couple of these. Let's do got Preston here. We have, of course, the original general outfit. Oh, that does not actually have the correct texture because I'm using a redone texture. Looks okay though. Not too glitchy as I tilt it. Let's fix it there. Put our axis back on Z. Yeah, it's not too glitchy. That'll do. I might put just a Minutemen woman's outfit on the actual armor stand. Yeah. So for now, I'll keep going and look for those plants. I might actually have one in my inventory right now. I tend to gather up all the Minutemen stuff that I can find as I'm traveling from store to store. Oh, the Patriotic Eagle. I know where that's going. I won't hang any of my propaganda banners in here. We'll keep it looking a bit nicer. Placement of those is just bothering me a bit. Let me grab that potted plant. Let's try it right here. Which would make it roughly right there as well. To get it to match, I'm going to have to scale them down. Let's do 2 units. And then put them like right there. So 1, 2. And just on the edge there. That looks pretty good. It's at least balanced now. Unlike these lights, which are in weird places and still need their power. Okay. I'm gonna get rid of one of these display cases and replace it with a painting of the Minutemen. We're gonna have to scale it down a couple of times to get it to fit, of course. Then I can place a small table or something underneath to fill the space. What do we have? There we are. And I already know what I want to put there, so I'm going to go right to OC Decorator. Where are you? There you are. Household decorations. Do I have few vases I can place? Or is this even the right category? Yes, it is. Just a small floral decorative vase. After looking at it again, that texture glitching around the collar is really bothering me, so I'm going to go back to those mannequins and put them both back. Cool. That is most definitely floating. While we're under decorations, I believe I have some nice red carpeting right there. Turn surface snapping off for just a minute. And then a rug for the door, snapping back on. Size that one down once to make it fit. Ah, man, I love that resizing tool in place everywhere. That's fantastic. Just get the exact results that I want immediately. You know, guys, I'm thinking about putting some kind of curtain up. Let's make a save first to cover up the utility room just a bit. That could look kind of cool. Because it's the apocalypse, we're having to make use of the space in our giant monolithic castle fortress building. But we're also trying to make it look kind of nice. It's a shower curtain, but hey. I'll have to get some power armor for that. I guess we do have room for more paintings here in the entranceway. Some very large paintings, of course. I'll resize them twice for in here. That is the outside railing. And perhaps a portrait of some kind. General Washington. Oh yeah, that would be an inspiration to recruits. Been fleshing out the classroom area just a bit. Looking good. So you march right up here. Let's put a door on this too. Doors. Let's make it nice. Let's make it a nice blue door. And I'll have to do that to get through it again. Huh. Is that secure, though? This is the actual fortress, even though the first floor is a classroom and a museum. I'm just realizing, too, that I am super low on wood. I completely forgot to go get more before recording this. That's gonna make things difficult. Yeah, I'm gonna go to homemaker doors, guys, because I need some more options. I want it to be a strong door. Oh, well, here we go. Bunker door. That's about as strong as it gets. Perfect. Let's get that power line run for those other lights. Grab, where is it? That switch would work. That should have plenty of range. I'm going to have one central connector, though. I'll use this little tiny one. There's our light. Don't want it to be too out of alignment. So the power armor is going to go there. Any decorations on this wall? Thinking about a light for the stairs too. At least maybe outside of the utility room. Sorry guys, that was probably dizzying. It's a nice small light I could use. Ooh, I bet Homemaker actually has some that cast shadows. Gotta use them sparingly. Let's see. Those actually cast some light. Look at that. Hmm. These are centerpiece lights, guys. I kind of want them to cast the shadows and be a bit brighter. Let's lower them down like that. Maybe right there. Still not aligned. That looks nice. I'm thinking some kind of, utility light for the utility room. That's got pretty glitchy shadows. I like the shadows, but I want it to be clean looking. How about this one right here? That one doesn't light up correctly. I lied, Homemaker didn't quite have what I was looking for. Going back to our primary lights. Industrial wall light red. Well, that's way too ominous. It cast right into the museum. There's all of our fancy lights. There we go. Classic vault style light. Which should help with the stairwell light as well. Just what I was looking for, guys. I'll probably put some like employees only sign for the utility room. Did you know we could put like a reading chair in that alcove in the stairs? Hopefully none of the AI gets stuck in there. That chair does not fit the theme, though. How much wood did I waste on that? Okay, none, thankfully. Where's a nice... Yeah, there we go. Classy-looking chair? Or is that too classy? Hmm. Well, there's the stools I couldn't find earlier. Like, I think the red chair fits in best. Where'd it go? With the museum? Kind of that Victorian style? Yeah, this one right here. But does it look silly off in the alcove? Not too much, actually. Okay. Little reading nook for the library. And one more wall decoration check. For this side. Let's see. This would really have to be a small painting because of that curved shape. Nothing even slightly large would do it. Unless we resized it just crazy amounts. Well, there we go. Haven't placed the elk in a while. Get back there. Okay, this is where I need some help, guys. Does this look silly in the corner? Is it too much? I don't know. Let's do a quick save. You guys tell me what you think. What do I have for dropping some armor here? There's my general's uniform. That won't do. Rebel hoodie and outfit. The red bandana. Oh, you have to equip it. Well, I'm dumb. Fortunately for the mannequin, that belongs to me. So could the rebel actually work? Oh, it can. That's cool. I wore this for a while in Far Harbor. I don't think this mod is still available for download, but I still have my copy of it. It would be really cool, though, to outfit both of these mannequins with Minutemen clothes. Now for the display case, I guess I would just place whatever I want there. That's my actual M14. I don't want to drop that. I will leave my sword here, though. My actual Spirit of 1776 sword that I've been carrying since the beginning of the game. Probably about 20 hours in, I made this sword. I don't think it has any special effects because I've never found one that did. That is General Dave's actual sword, which I'll replace with a more a fancier one once I find one. That display case is most definitely clipping. I'll fix that real quick. If I use place everywhere to just kind of shift it over, yeah, that shouldn't cause it to glitch out. Now it fits. Yep. Well, I picked it up once again. So yeah, guys, I'll have to come around and find some neat things to put into the museum. I'll leave that as the surprise, but you guys could see how I laid it out. Might leave one of my pistols here too. I picked it up again. Anyway, I'll come back and populate the display cases later. Ooh, I could go back to Sanctuary and find some of my very early weapons from last November. Oh, wow, it's 2017 now. November 2015. I have played a lot of Fallout, guys. A lot. So there's our utility room. And the door is backwards. This is why we check things. Our utility room and our museum side by side. We got just a bit more time, so we can work on the tower some too. Handle needs to go on that side. There we are. Cozy little utility room. Partially hidden by curtains if we need them to be hidden. And that's... There we go. Fix that curtain. And I think that's a great baseline for the museum. Again, I just gotta find stuff to populate it with. If we go upstairs here, let me go slower so you guys don't get sick. This is the second floor, the defensive area. Probably gonna have communications desk in this corner, this turret. That's a prisoner area. I won't spoil that. But we've got pretty good sight lines out of all of these windows to down below. We can go on up to the rooftop. I'm still wearing my tidy whities. Oh man. Mannequin turned this into an Emperor's New Clothes story. The General's New Clothes. There we are. I still kind of want to do something with this platform, but for now it's, I don't know, just a platform. I gotta watch my frame rate too. I think I'm already down into the 40s in certain parts of the settlement. But for today, let me not get stuck. We're gonna wrap things up by working on this observation slash sniper's tower, which you can get to by dangerously dipping right into the edge of the shooting range, which is on. Let's cut all that off. But I built this elevator here, and I want to make sure it's not clipping. Requires power to function. Is that connected to the switch? All right. It is. Okay, yeah, it's not really clipping. Just the one arm strut is inside of the tower. That's fine. The elevator itself is not clipping. So we're going to go to the third floor here, over the target range, and I'll show you guys what I was laying out. This is the wooden platform attached to the silo that goes up here with a very narrow scaffolding stair. And then up here like this, and then around and around, ooh, narrow part. And then here we are, towering high above our boot camp. I want to add some supports, but first I've got to finish the structure itself. I'm pulling a Joel here, and I've forgotten the roof, but we're going to work on that next. There we are. Oh, this is all going to be wood, too. Hopefully I have enough. Let's get those corner pieces first. Those will be a bit expensive. Gonna put a solid cap on the outside. And a solid cap there. Okay, already a solid cap there and there. That's good. How about rooftops? Let's do runoff towards the outside, like that. I wanted this walled in to leave one protective wall on this side, but I really feel like, what's the point of there being a watchtower if you can't see in this direction? Yeah, I mean, we have the corners that are kind of concealment. None of this tower is what you would actually consider cover. Cover is something that could actually protect you. This is thin, corrugated steel. It's definitely just concealment. Yeah, I'll put a sash on this side too. That is some really good sight line right there. So, what do we want to put up here? Well, first of all, we're going to seal up these holes with these pieces like this. That worked out nicely. Those could be our seating areas with just like a single bunk bed. Let's take a look. Surface snapping back on. That's a pretty tight fit. That works though. We'll put one bed and one chair up here. Haven't used the airplane seats in a while. I'll put one of those down. For the center, we could have some storage and some additional seating. Put a bench right there. fancy chair. Do not want to store the floor. Containers. Kind of thinking a double container like this. Let's just turn off snapping entirely for surfaces for a second. Put that like that. I don't think I have any lockers that are part of the vanilla game. I'll have to go to my homemaker section for those, I think. We do have trunks, though. That's nice. Put one trunk in this corner. Lots of supplies up here. Here's a locker. What else up here? Maybe one more chair in that corner. So the idea behind this tower, guys, which I'm guessing I should probably explain before I get too far. Do a Nuka-Cola chair in this corner. Think of it as an additional layer to the shooting range down below. Put some targets up there or off in the distance and practice your long-range shooting. But if you guys also remember, we built that guard tower over there a while back. This is kind of the central guard tower to look past these silos that they're on top of, which would normally be blocking our view. So, yeah, basically just a way to get around the sight lines blocked by the silos. No blind spots for the defenses of the Minutemen boot camp. I might put one tower or something on top of the cafeteria, like a small watchtower. But of course, our central fort overlooks the central area and all those lower walls. So that's plenty of defenses for down there. What else do we have here? I was looking for a table. That's right, I was going to do a table. So I put that Nuka-Cola chair in the corner right there. Let's just give him a standard end table. Oh, I know what else I want to do. I want to put some shelving along this way, because if this is going to be used as a target shooting area, you're going to want a bench to put your rifle on. So I'm actually going to enlarge this shelf. Push it over this way, not the whole room, just the shelf. And lower it down. Not the whole room again. Enlarge, enlarge, enlarge. And now we have our shooting platform. You can crouch with your rifle like that. And I actually like that a lot, so I'm gonna do the same thing for the other sides. No, not that bench side. Let's just do one over here. I think Place Everywhere actually has a copy and paste. I just don't know how to use it. Trying to get it where the supports right there are not clipping into anything. There we have it, guys. That's our basic furniture. I'm not gonna put a door on this because I feel like opening a door up this high would be pretty dangerous. I will, however, take a look at the homemaker decorations category. and see what cool stuff we could possibly add in here. So decorations and homemaker and miscellaneous. Exterior. Got some fans. Lots of garden and playground stuff. Got an access ladder, but really nowhere for it to connect to. A ceiling fan. Well, there's actually no electricity up here, so that couldn't work. Put a box down just for some clutter. And an empty one with it. Ooh, a chalkboard. Now this could be useful. If I could just find somewhere that it would fit. This could be used for marking people who are coming and going or spottings. I'll just shrink it down like that to make it fit in the corner. Give it just a little bit of tilt. What am I stuck on? Oh, the chair. And they will, of course, need a radio. Kind of the first alert system up here. Anything else useful? Lots of interior, like, bathroom stuff. I think that's good. Let's see what else we have under special. I think I'm also missing some categories from Nuka World. I should see if I can fix my SKE here, Settlement Keywords Extender, and get some of that fixed. So where does that leave us? I think just small props for in here, and I won't do a whole bunch of that, guys, because I don't want to spend a whole bunch of time on the interior here. Yeah, I'll save the small props for just me on my own, because I want to show you guys how I'm planning to add the supports for this. Instead, I'm just going to add a crappy end table to up here in the corner. Cool. Let's take a look. I may have to fly around some with the console command for this. I don't like how those stairs are clipping through, but I don't really have a choice because... Yeah, let me go into free cam. That looks a little bit wonky, but... Unless I just lower these two sections, that could work. Yeah, let's try that, guys. So if I use place everywhere to get rid of this awkwardly clipping staircase, do this. Do not fall off the edge, Dave. Jeez. I'm not building in God mode. You guys have seen that I'm actually having to construct these objects with my settlement's resources, which means if I fall off of this tower in workshop mode, having not saved, I am going to die and have to reload my save. So let's not fall off the tower, shall we? Okay, I'm going to do that platform like that. That now needs to come like this and this. It's looking appropriately rickety. And now I should be able to grab a piece of the floor here. Or the traditional wooden stairs, the small ones. Let's see. Alright. Will that work like that? I think it will. Well, with the clipping stairs fixed, I am going to have to, I think, fly now because I want to get these placed. And they're going to work a bit like this. Yeah, I've got to fly in order to place them. And then you can only place them once, and then you got to turn the flying off and on again. There we go. That's what I wanted, the extra rotation. Almost had it. Just falling each time a bit more. If I don't hit that fast enough, I'm gonna die. I really need to be more careful. So then this could connect out with the elevator. What other elevator stuff do we have? Or the scaffolding, I guess, is the technical category. Some of my cabin in the wood mod stuff. Looking forward to trying that. Can we use this? I think we can. If we do it like this. Oh yeah, that's looking nice and rickety. That's gonna clip through a little bit, but that's still not as noticeable as it was before. Then I'll put a floor section, turning object snap back on. That like that. And that'll just leave there, I think. So then I can place a timber. Wow, look at that. That is super rickety. Okay. I can place a timber, which would be under my wood miscellaneous category. No, structures. Miscellaneous category. Yeah, here we go. Place one of these timbers like this. I'll do two of them. And with just a bit of resizing, they'll work great. Let's turn off flying here. Nope, not you. Resize you. And resize you. Hopefully I can actually walk up this thing. There we go. Had to make an actual step out of it. Whew. Okay, yeah, quick save time, guys. Getting nervous here. So this also needs some supports. Seen it's jutting out quite far. I'm gonna burn through the rest of my supply of wood here. Gonna have to fly again to get this next one out. These, though, are the details that really help to sell a place, as I've said probably 100 times before. Makes it look real and lived in. That one there, and that one there. That one there. And perhaps one like that. And one right here. I'll have to go back around and just fix those a tiny bit. Toggle and toggle. Oh, if I scale it, I can't move it again. That sucks. Kind of getting the hang of where to stop, though. So that's good. Whew. That is super rickety. Just a few more like that should do it. Oh. Don't move the main piece. What am I doing? Alright guys, that covers the supports for the primary building and for the scaffolding over the elevator. Oh, that's floating. That won't do. Scale both of those up. I'm outside of the workshop. So, let's actually just use place everywhere to turn that off. And then, it's really just a matter of placing a couple more of those supports, guys. And then I think that's where we're gonna stop for today's build video. There we go. So let's go back to wood and then floors. No, miscellaneous. There we are. We're gonna fly one last time. Oh! I was already flying. That was close. I almost killed myself right at the end of the episode. I'm gonna turn object snapping off. And again, we'll have to shift these a little bit after we place them. Make sure they're not clipping through like crazy. And I already have some supports under that one. And I'll be going through and adding some rickety wooden railings and stuff like that. Let's toggle that. That's what I'm looking for. Actually, I don't think that piece works at all, so I'm gonna actually just put that away. I'll get some smaller pieces. Don't rotate by yourself. There we go. Nope, there it goes. Alright. Get now. Alright. I can't quite figure out if this is a workshop bug or a place everywhere bug, but occasionally the rotation just gets a little bit wild. I was trying to do it in here too. Well, might as well place a piece of decorative plywood down while I'm up here. Okay. I am gonna have to go to the wood and then the floor section to get just a small scrappy piece. Is It's gotta be something that can just clip right into the silo. So we'll go with that piece. That should do it. This still needs to be rotated a bit like this. There we go. Alright guys, this is going to take a while, so I'm going to go ahead and end the recording here for today. Hope you've enjoyed this bit of building, and I'm going to keep going for a bit. Get all of these supports lined up, add some rickety railings, and then start adding some micro decoration here for the tower. But yeah, lots of fun on this build. Always a lot of fun to shift direction from the previous one, going from Somerville Sanctuary with its misty ricketiness to this kind of a power statement for the Minutemen. At least General Dave's Minutemen. We are here to stay, and our recruits are going to make sure that's the case. Thanks for watching, guys, and I'll see you next time. Thank you.